so that happened. We were out trying to film a little segment for Legends Media in the Ric Flair E91 wagon, and I thought we would end the night with a killer burnout shot for the video. Part of the majority of the reason I actually converted this car to rear-wheel drive and manual was because I wanted to do burnouts. And so finally I got an opportunity and we destroyed the car. So, little rundown. So the car is pretty much custom as far as the body goes and everything, and it does have an N54 twin turbo drivetrain in it. 350 horsepower should be enough to do a burnout in this car. Unfortunately, when I built this thing, so I might have went a little overboard on the wide body kit on this car. It's a Liberty Walk wide body that was made for an E92 M3 that I modified to fit the E91 chassis and rear doors. As you can see, it's really wide. It's 50 millimeters wider in the rear on each side. That said, I had to put a 13.5-inch wide wheel on the rear. So I have 325 30-19 tires, and there are 888s from Toyo. So they're super sticky race compound. Normally that wouldn't be that big a deal, but when you're trying to do burnouts and you have a stock engine set up with 350 horsepower, it's gonna be a little bit of a push to actually break those tires loose. So I wanted to get the shot for you guys. I wanted to send it. So I went ahead and put a little bit of extra air pressure in the rear. We did the shoot, and finally at the end, we decided to give it a try. My first mistake was trying to actually shift through gears while I was doing the burnout. I wanted to do a really nice rolling burnout and end the video properly, but unfortunately, once I went to make that shift, it actually destroyed the ring gear and pinion gear in the differential, and also snapped one of the axles at the carrier bearing. Got some pretty bad damage to the rear end of the car, but we were trying to do something really cool for you guys. Unfortunately, it didn't work out. The plan is to actually get a new rear end, put a different limited slip differential in it, and also potentially get some beefier axles. At that point, I know that the drivetrain can handle it, and at that point, I can also start adding some horsepower to this thing, which is the goal. So in the near future, I'll be ordering all the bits to make this thing proper again. I'll get down to the hunt quarters, get all the stuff installed with the boys. So now that we know what's wrong with the car, I'm gonna have to jump on throttle and do a search for a rear end, maybe a M3 rear end, or potentially just another 335 rear end, a new limited slip differential, and probably a couple axles. If you guys have any of those parts laying around, please list them on throttle. I'll swoop them up. All right, well, that's pretty much it. So stay tuned for the fix of the Ric Flair wagon and the video and pictures that are gonna follow.